So, the game is starting and we should start having fun as well. Although this session will probably be a bit more boring since Poland, our savior, the powerful beardless beard, isn't here. And also, Spain isn't played by anyone right now, which is pretty sad because he is one of the strongest countries right now, has most of the new world. The AI will probably fuck it up. Destroy it. Anything else worth noting? Austria is played by a reserve. So maybe he'll get Austria to greatness in a better fashion. At least he has his Hungary, although without Transylvania. I don't have anything to say because nothing interesting happened. They all have mostly the same borders as 3 sessions ago. Nothing much. Spain AI instantly declared war on more natives. Burgundy got a free pass in expanding in Africa. The Asians, more specifically the Indians, are wrapping up most of Indonesia. Moving on to the Philippines soon, I guess. Oh, that 94 over extension. So, the players in Asia are the Mughals, Bharat, Hindustan, and Ayutthaya. And also Japan, let's not forget of Japan. If I'm not mistaken, half of the last session they were played by an AI, and that's why they weren't able to conquer Ming. Which managed to. Last time, for a short period of time, Ming was a great power. Don't know what changed. They've got a lot of high development provinces over here. Japan conquered 4 regions, but they were such a high development that they had to accept it instantly. And Japan is making a nice incursion into Siberia because, as I understand, he doesn't want to make any colonial nations until he manages to get rid of Western trade. On the other hand, Hindustan is on his way to making a Californian colony. Ethiopia is centralizing his grip on southern Africa. However, it seems that they lost Motapa for some reason to rebels. Yeah, pretty much. Interesting. Hindustan got in a war with Mughals against Oman. They'll probably want to get some naval bases there. Morocco has been relegated to some provinces in the middle of the desert, more or less. England is trying to take Peru. While Spain probably won't take much more. So it seems that because of this, because of the fact that Spain is not played right now, England will probably win the colonizing game. He will have the most territories in America since Spain is not played and Hindustan just started. So he won't have enough time to make a great foothold before most of the stuff has been conquered by Great Britain. So, moving on, Hindustan is at war with Oman, with the Mughals. Ottomans are at war with Mamluks, finally finishing them off, took them a lot of time. And Great Britain is at war with Peru, probably trying to make their colonial mission in Peru. They're able to embrace printing press at quite a low cost. I'm wondering why they are doing it. They also can take into all their respective weird. Okay, any other war? Nope, everyone is at peace. Except for these people. Let's look at how Mughals and Hindustan are destroying us. Oh man. For some reason he only asked for Hindustan and not for Bharat, so I'm pretty sure they're trying to get some naval bases over here. Okay then, because there's nothing to talk about, let's go country by country and observe their situation. So, let's start with Ethiopia. They didn't join the war against the Mamluks to get more Egyptian land because they're problem right now is probably reconquering Mutapa. They're staying at negative stability because stability actually cost them quite a lot. Let's see their holy sites. They have three and they lack this one and this one. Wonder if the Ottomans will give it to them sometimes. They're going at quite a lot of deficit because of corruption. They probably had a corruption. No, it's either the AI. It has to be the AI who goes to over to corruption. Well, anyways, their income is quite okay for an African. He stays on a lot of forts. for some reason, a lot of forts in his capital region where nobody should be able to reach. Wondering what's up about that. Some borders. Yeah, these ones make sense, but the center ones, especially the one on the capital, which is gone there. Wondering why he's keeping them. Eh. Anyway, so that's the issue. Let's look at his religious map. And he still has a lot of land to convert. For some reason, he converted these before these. I don't know why. Yeah, let's look at his accepted cultures. So he accepted Swahili, and these ones are accepted because it's the culture group and he's an empire. So most of his land is accepted, which probably is the reason why he has so much income. Okay, our next guy is Austria. How's Austria doing? So, is he the emperor? Yes, he is the emperor. Oh, look, the league. The religious leagues, which every player probably ignored until now, except Brandenburg and Poland. Wonder who will protect Austria from them. Well, right now Austria is stronger than the alliance, I mean. Probably the empire will stay Catholic if more people won't join Brandenburg in his plea. So we got diplomatic, economic and defensive. Economic, interesting choice for the emperor. His income is at just a little bit above Ethiopia. He's staying with a level 3 advisor. With interesting. Does he have too much? Yep, he has too much diplomatic. So that's why he thinks he doesn't need it. His heir is an interesting fellow. I would disinherit him, but then he would have negative prestige, which would hinder all of his plans probably. So right now he is trying to take the rest of Italy because it's up for grabs. Italy is pretty free right now since it's only Tuscany and Parma and Siena. Nobody has allies. Sadly for Austria, he wouldn't be able to form Italy even if we switched cultures because Genoa is held by Spain. If that's his plan, who knows? Okay, I think he had a little problems with some centers of reformation in Italy, but that is fixable. And also his personal union, Hungary, which Austria had a lot of problem with. Yep, at least he has it right now without Transylvania, but still, and some of Slovakia. So next up we're going to look at the Mughals, which conquered a lot of Oman, so they have a lot of extension it seems, but they didn't give anything to Hindustan. So why did they call Hindustan in this war? Wasn't paying much attention though. So what's their position? They've got a higher income. Their forts are cheaper. Is it from one of their ideas? Yep, it's from the defensive idea. Okay, oh, they went innovative. Probably for the war exhaustion. Yeah. And cheaper advisors, but he doesn't even have an diplomatic advisor on like Austria. What are his next expansion plans, except for the rest of India? As I recall, his plan was probably to take the rest of his culture group, which was this one. Right now he stopped for some reason, temporarily. and he's on hold. He took Oman and not much player interaction except for selling a victory card to Bharat. Next one is Mr. Observer that nobody cares about. Next we have Brandenburg, which managed to take a good chunk of Bohemia and also accepted its culture. He went Orthodox, of course. He had a deal with Muscovy in order to become Orthodox, probably to enjoy a free casus belli to burn heretics, and also for that sweet patriarch authority that got buffed in 1.18 and doesn't have any drawbacks. So it gives quite a lot of bonuses. How's his income going? Well, he's still on the low side though. He won't be able to create Prussia in the near future because Sweden has complete control over the Teutons. So his plan right now is to expand into Germany as aggressively as possible. Yeah. Anything else? His alliance as well. His ally with Sweden, his arch nemesis, Muscovy, his arch nemesis' ally, and Austria, because, you know, we need to have that imperial ally. And also, it seems he has Saxony as a vassal, so right now it's an expansionist policy into Germany. Yeah, nothing much to say, as usual. Next one is Great Britain, which declared war on one province minor in Argentina, I guess. Nope, in Peru. Let's see, is it Argentina or Peru? Nope, it's still Argentina, although the area is called Peru. Yeah, nice. Well, now we see at least scoring to finish his colonial nation. Yeah, he's on his way to finishing British Peru. He also has Third Wars Canada. He's creating the normal Canada, I guess. And those are his colonial nations right now. So Argentina and America, close to finishing Peru, and next Canada, I guess. Okay, so anything else? Let's look at the income. So, a sizable income, what can I say? Let's look a little bit at the English Channel trade power. Yeah, Burgundy is stealing a lot of trade, which is being sent here by England. Too bad. Oh. He finished his war and declared the next one almost instantly. On Charca, he probably thinks he'll finish up Peru by the time he wraps up the war with Charca, so he'll already give it to his colonial nation. Okay, so right now all of his attention is turned to the New World. He went quality first, then exploration, so he explored rather late, which gave Spain the colonization institution, since it was the only one who had the possibility. And next he had economic and offensive. Interesting. So he's trying to go for as good an army as possible in order to protect himself from his continental enemies, since he has a sizable land in Europe from the partition of France. He got Paris. Yeah. I guess Great Britain should embrace Icelandic identity. I mean, it would be the best choice ever. Isn't it right, guys? Yep. So this is all for Great Britain. Let's look at the next guy on the list, which is Ottomans, who have a lot of force on their border with Austria, probably to deter any European transgressions. He finally conquered more of the Mamluks, but the Mamluks still exist. They're still kicking. More and more and more. Kind of low on the advisors. Where is all his money going? How many? So, he's got a lot of corruption. And he's not rooting it at maximum. Also, his ideas are administrative quality and defensive. It's not that shabby. Anything else? Oh yeah, let's look at his army. So, how big is his army? Oh, he has already 118,000 troops. Where are they? So we got 44 here. 30. Oh, okay. Well, so he has quite a sizable army. That's where most of his money is going right now. He probably has the biggest army by far. Nope, Spain is actually pretty close because of his quantity ideas. However, since Spain is played by the AI right now, it doesn't matter that much. Anything else? How is he with his He's kind of slow on the conversion, probably because of the lack of ideas, and also I don't know if he realized he should. Oh no, he actually gave all these provinces to the Dimi, probably for the Paranas of Hiddens. He should at least try and make them loyal. So for the technology cost, I mean, why would you give them territories just for shits and giggles? Okay, so that's about it for the Ottomans. They're going on their way to finishing Mamluks, probably in the next 50 years. I guess this was their third war, fourth. Wondering what kind of idea group they will take next. Oh, that's quite a good hair. Okay, so next one on the list is Ayutthaya, which surrounded Langsang, but Langsang still has some allies. But Ayutthaya has quite a huge army for how small he is. Or is it just my impression? Nope, he actually has 500 development, so it's not that bad. He's doing pretty well for himself, considering when he started playing. He started to already have his common border with the Indians, and most certainly he will start conquering into China after he finishes with Langsang. Hopefully that's how you pronounce it. I don't know. Income-wise, at least he's better than Brandenburg. He's very low in ideas, though. Very, very low in ideas. I would suggest him wait until he gets some ideas going on, because that's pretty bad. Well, he doesn't have that good of ideas though. Again, another one that doesn't have all of his advisors in, but at least he has a problem with money, and that's why he isn't using one. Next off, we have Hindustan, who sits comfortably at his 500 development for quite some time. Again, they aren't trying to finish up the Indian states, and the only reason I can think about it is to not have victory cards on one another, which already became mutable. Ignoring that, he took all the island of Malaya and half of Java, because it was a victory card that actually was Bharat's before, but he got it because he has a victory card on it. These guys really like to trade victory cards. Okay, so he's doing counter-spionage on Spain, while Spain isn't spying on him. Well, I don't really care. Do as he must. So, what else can I say about Hindustan? He's making more from trade than England, at least. Let's see here. So if we go at economy, not total I want from trade. So Spain is first, Ottomans is second, and Hindustan is third. Let's see where global trade is able to spawn. So right now global trade should spawn in Bengal, which would be pretty interesting to see. Okay, so he has Malaya, and he's very close to finishing his colonial nation, and England is trying to block him. Interesting. England is trying to make enemies of the Indians. So, I think that's about it for Hindustan. His next expansion will probably be in his east, and probably he will take the rest of Java, since Bharat isn't interested anymore. Yeah, okay, so next off, we have Burgundy, which will either try to make Dutch or France. France is a bit harder, although all it would take would be a war against Great Britain. If he wins one war with Great Britain in which he takes Paris and Maine, he would be able to create France. It's actually harder for him to create Netherlands right now, because Utrecht is allied with Austria, so Austria is trying to stop him from expanding into the Netherlands. What more can I say, except for the fact that he named his capital Paris, while Paris has been renamed to New Lancashire. And he took quite a sizable chunk of France, of central France. which gave him the best opportunity to create friends. Yeah. Their ideas are influence for easier annexation of his personal unions, which he already finished. Quantity to have a bigger mercenary pool, and expansion to colonize. He got his maps from his allies, I guess. And also to reach India, because as far as I know, he has a long history of hatred with the Indians. Next up, we have Muscovy. Wait, beforehand we should talk about this war, because the Asians declared quite a big war on Korea and Ming, with a focus on Korea. Well, their armies are pretty big, of course, Barat being half of it, but let's look at Korea. Korea's army is only half. Well, Korea's alliance army is only half. And this war, of course, was declared on by Japan, which has quite a sizable help from Barat. Yeah, well, this war won't be that hard for them, I guess. Harder on Ayutthaya, because Ayutthaya will be the one occupied, at least partially. But not much to say, really. Won't be that hard. Okay, so let's go back to Muscovy, which is conquering Buryatia. Buryatia. Oh yeah, of course, this country, right? Giving it to Irat, his vassal. Yeah. So, Muscovy is huge, conquered most of Lithuania, the rest of it was made march by Poland when he was actually playing. Got a nice and sizable chunk of land. He went up to the Caucasus, has half of Crimea, well, not half, a third of Crimea, a third is Polish and a third is Turkish. And right now he's actually going hard on the hordes. Breaking Kazakh, he took Oirat in a troll war, because Oirat lost a lot of his land to Shun. Since Oirat was actually a neighbor of Muscovy, Muscovy declared on him, Oirat lost his war, but then Muscovy was still able to vassalize him in order to gain this this nice little vessel surrounded by sweet and juicy targets. The emperor changed, so 050. Yep, Emperor Reiner the First, an 050, the best. Wait, for some reason, Austria is allied with Tuscany, but why? You should conquer Tuscany. Maybe he's hoping for a personal union, who knows. Well, anyways, back to the point. So, he can form Russia, but he doesn't want to. Something probably having to do with victory cards and abusing them, of course. He has religious, administrative, and defensive. Quite good for expanding, like he does. So, his Buryat separatists went all the way to Novgorod. Well, nothing more to say here. I mean, he's conquering stuff. What more is there to say? His heir isn't that good with administrating his country, but point sticks, he will have. Next off, we have Japan, which is in his great war with Korea, in which he already conquered most of all of Korea, except for Yukjin. And he's now going into Manchuria, while Ayutthaya is protecting from Ming. And also he has Chu as an ally. Interesting. Chu being this country, right, okay. So he's got exploration, economic, and quantity. He still didn't explore anything on the new world, because, as I said before, his plan is to not colonize the new world until he gets global trade, so he won't have the Western trade modifier when he meets Europeans. And this war will go rather smoothly. Let's look at some of the development. He did develop his capital a bit. What more can I say? His income is on par with, I don't know, Ethiopia, as I recall. His war is going very, very well right now, no problems. Except Ayutthaya is fighting hard for the war. Let's look at this. This might be lost. If he had some bad dice rolls, he actually might have lost this. Oh, he retreated. I think he was winning. My bad. So, well, the conquest of Korea and Ming is on its way. Next off, Sweden, that didn't start conquering Norway yet, because Norway has a lot of allies, a lot of random allies. He probably liberated Finland in order to give a victory card to Muscovy, of course. Right now he had some problems with rebels that he solved it. Denmark is still a one province country, and he has most of the Livonian Order and all of the Teutonic Order. And most of Pomerania, if not all, not all of Pomerania. Stralsund isn't his. Stralsund, yep. Okay, so he is allied with both of his neighbors, and Great Britain, if you consider him a sea neighbor. So he probably has just a peaceful life ahead of him to convert the rest of his country to Protestant. Yeah, not many opportunities to expand, but at the same time not many opportunities to be conquered. So yeah, peaceful. Sweden will probably be peaceful in the near future, or helping his allies. And last off, we have Bharat, which has all of his forts mothballed like a good little kid, and he's helping with all of his army the conquest of China, East Asia minus Japan. Yeah, well, Bharat has quite a lot of development. 1000. He is he's kind of behind on his ideas, but not as bad as Ayutthaya. Probably would want to finish the expansion ideas and also the trade ideas sometimes. He started trade ideas, so he is probably aiming to get some sweet trade, but where? Because he can't take it into Ceylon without going in Bengal. Actually, trade ideas are quite a bad idea. He's actually taking all of the Malaccan trade into Bengal. What can I say? It's his plan. He, in my opinion, he should try to conquer the rest of the Moluccas and get the trade there. Even if Hindustan already has the center of trade in Malacca. Wait, all of this is Mala Moluka, so Moluka. Yeah, right now Barat could be able, if he takes Malapa hit, Majapa hit, could be able to take most of the trade there, but it's his plan. Who knows where he's actually trying to use all of those Americans that he'll have. Well, and that about sums it up. Sweden declared, no, Muscovy declared the crusade on another horde, I guess. Is it a horde? Nope, it's one of the Ming throwaways, as it seems. He actually managed to conquer a lot of Oiras, so that's why he's that far off. Although his capital should be around here, yep. Yep. And also, any other interesting war that started? Brandenburg went on and advanced in his expansionist policy. They'll probably create a coalition because he doesn't care anymore. The Holy Roman Empire doesn't have much strength left. If I recall correctly, Austria is at war with Württemberg. Wait, he lost Kors. Oh, that was a conquest, not a reconquest. No, it is a reconquest on... Oh, he vassalized Switzerland, yep, yep. He vassalized Switzerland, now he's retaking his Kors. Okay, any other wars? Mughals finally started to conquer their motherland. Yep, nothing more to say right now. I did a quick 1 hour overview of all the countries. Well, 3/4 of an hour, but who really cares? So, let's just visit the diplomacies of people and talk with them. Hi guys.
Hello.
How's the conquest of China going?
It's going actually way easier than I expected, to be honest. Because they didn't really put that much fight into it, I think.
Yeah. They just ran away and sieged them everything else.
But are someone dealing with those rebels? Or
I'm going back.
Or am I supposed to do all the war?
I'm going back. Just killed the Korean army here.
Yeah.
Sieged some stuff.
Oh, just 60 peasant regiments. Well, that's not bad at all.
Yeah, but they should have our tech, and I'm sending more troops over there just now.
Oh. Yeah. Squirrel army is quite good at running away.
So how much is Ming at now?
78.
How's the game going, guys, in more general terms?
Well, we are quite afraid of Muscovy right now, because he has a vassal in Eurat, so he's getting pretty close, and we have just gotten printing press too.
Yeah, but still need
to... say again?
Still need time till it is present.
I still don't know how did he make Oyata Vaza.
Yeah, it's weird. I'd like to see a replay on that.
Oirat lost a lot of cores to Shun. He actually was bordering Muscovy. Muscovy declared on him, but Shun conquered Oirat.
Oh, okay, that makes sense.
If anyone wants to sell me a province to get the institution, I just embraced it. And I have Suez, so I can get stuff on the Indian Sea.
I'm getting it just in a moment anyway.
Let me think about that.
Yeah, Muka might be interested.
Well, he borders me, so he's already getting some, but it would be nice if it also happened on the other way around.
It should go faster, though. Yeah,
okay, so those three provinces for you. And those two provinces for Ayutthaya, yeah?
Yes.
Okay. That's a 58 war score.
Well, they must be done soon, though.
92. I think I can make a 100 war score deal right now.
Yeah, just the three provinces, or at least one and the two to Ayutthaya from Ming.
Okay.
I found gold!
What the fuck are you doing, Sweden?
Sweden is doing this up.
I think Muscovy is attacking too, Ming.
Yeah, Muscovy actually almost completely occupied Shun.
We need to get him.
Okay, I'm separate piercing Ming now.
Yeah? That'll be nice.
There it is.
Great.
Did you get all?
Yeah, I got the three, and what about the Yucha? Yeah.
Yeah.
That's fine. Holy shit, that's a lot of rebels. I'm dealing with the rebels just now.
And I'm killing the Korean army here at Kapchatka.
Yeah, Spain going hard.
I separate this Shun right now, okay? We don't need Shun anything from it. You're right?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's at least what I gathered. Or else we can do it in another war.
If you can siege down that 14th South Korea, that will be the war score province.
The one Kyung something.
Yeah, I will never pronounce that.
Ottoman is no longer a valid rival.
Ooh. Did you eclipse him or did he eclipse you?
I'm not sure.
I eclipse him by get the power projection indicator.
I wanted the memes to be real.
Well, I just got land, so I'm telling myself that it's because I eclipsed him.
Yeah, sure.
Oh, call for war, call for peace. Okay.
Yeah, I'm just going to siege it down now.
Hopefully you'll conquer China faster than the Ottomans conquered the Mamluks, because they didn't finish in their fifth war or something.
The rest of the Mamluks are for Ethiopia.
Indeed, it looks that way. And you'll probably give Syria to them as well, right?
Yeah, he's getting Aleppo and Iskandria, Alexandria for the blessings, and the rest is mine.
Yeah. Well, okay, guys, I'm going to talk to you later.
The capital is done. Yeah, sure thing, Roborick.
See
you. Okay.
Nice talking to you.
Now let us join the Europeans, for I really have nothing else to say right now. I mean, what can I say about their wars of conquest in China? Or the wars of the troll wars of Burgundy that conquer inland Africa, because of course that's what Burgundy is doing, it's conquering inland Africa. Great Britain is at war with the Pope because AI Spain asked him to help. Of course. So, Austria as well. Interesting. Spain asked for all of his allies in this silly little war. The Pope is at war with most of Europe. Now that's a good Pope. Nice, nice diplomacy. Okay, so let's go and chat it up with the Europeans, at least part of them.
I think he will. Can you just leave Saxon for now?
I don't need though. We can manage it. I just don't like him here.
But it's. I don't know. I don't like it. Just can you just leave him? Let him leave.
Ooh,
like
one moment. Possible succession war. The ruler of Bavaria died.
But. Please
one
don't unpost.
Yeah, you shouldn't pause for that shit.
It's crap. Palatine is out to Austria, and I wanted to take over land from the Palatine.
I think we should go.
Why would you take land from Palatine?
The thing is, I can contest Bavaria.
You can
well, I don't
Bavaria,
think Austria
do.
Will allow it.
Well, yeah.
You will fight Austria, and I have troops in China, you know. I can't help you.
I think Ottoman can help you to ask.
I asked Austria to break the lines, let's see what happens.
I think he's not that dumb. Oh, sorry.
Crap. My rival picks are Austria, Poland, Sweden.
Why not me, Yoda?
Maybe if you actually backed Austria for the emperorship, he would let you, but right now you're backing Poland.
Holy shit, he gave...
Oh, we made a joke about Poland, and we said, let's have a Poland AI emperor. Sounds like fun.
I don't want AI Poland. AI Poland is bad. He attacks me.
You kind of deserved it, probably.
No, I didn't deserve it. I get lands mostly peacefully, you know? It was agreement between players that I take this lands from my war. After we win our war, of course, but whatever. I have a lot of manpower now.
I'm holding this possible succession war thing, but what happens if I hold it?
6 months.
Crap, I declare the war. Crap, I declare the war.
Are you fucking kidding me? Let's just hope that Austria will not join, because...
Yeah, I'm pretty sure Austria will, but I'm...
Crap.
Promise him that you will not get a union.
Austria can't call in Spain, right? Because if he can't, I'll join your war.
He can't. It will be only Austria.
I think we should help Brandenburg then.
Yeah, it wasn't intentional.
Well,
Austria joined, but he said, I won't fight you.
I have only 20k in Europe.
Hungary will fight you.
I'm gonna offer him white peace.
That's going to cost him Diplo.
Why?
Not
offer Austria
white peace.
Why is it going to cost him Diplo?
They changed this page.
Reputation.
I died. Not, my AR is at 543. It won't cost him diplo reputation.
Yes, it does. If you white piece right now, you get minus one diplomatic reputation,
okay,
for 10
so
years or something.
Can I have some help against not Austria? Planet.
But I have 23k. I can help you, but most
yeah,
of
Austria
my troops are in China.
Yeah, 23k is more than enough. We have 53,000, more than all these people over here.
And I
can,
don't have,
I can help you.
Just call me.
Who said that?
Burgundy.
Burgundy.
You hate me. Here, have a royal marriage. Thank you.
I can already allow you, but sure.
Also, I have. It seems like I have a rebel, so I need to take care of them. But it will be 1 sec, I think.
So, 2nd of August, I can offer. Here. Crap. I was just clicking through offers and it was like. I was clicking the hotkey and apparently the hotkey said declare, so I declared the war.
Burgundy, we attack?
I offered you the...
Yeah, I know. Can you wait a little bit with declaring me?
Yeah, so Sweden, can I call you in for the 23 stack?
Yes, but I need to take care of my rebels first.
Or you could just offer Conda Yeri so that you don't have... Oh, you can offer 20k. Whatever. So, Burgundy, are you good for calling in?
Are you actually fighting Austria or...?
Austria? No, Austria's gonna sit over there and do nothing.
Yeah, then I can join.
Sure, so, thank you.
I'll just go for Utrecht first.
Just call me in. I will join you with 23k if you need me. How much
Utrecht is a couple major, and that is a shame.
Well, while the foreign was full,
we got
I hate
nice
such things. It was accidental, and now we have to fight.
I will appreciate that you will not get Bavaria, you know?
I wanted so much.
Or
to... Well, let's win the war, and then we can think about something. This needs to be won anyway.
Well, I
won't
Bavaria, bro.
Okay, you will get Bavaria, right?
Well,
ooh, I just stack-wiped something. I don't know, I just stack-wiped something.
Do,
I don't know
do you
I
have
stack-wiped
a general or something?
Yes, I have a 2-3 do. Ooh. No, kill Utrecht. Utrecht army, kill.
Those Chinese forts are very good.
Is it stack for the forum? No.
So, as I gathered from spying on them, because I was more or less stealthily staying there, they'll probably take Bavaria from Austria. Well, not from Austria, from the Palatinate. But quite an interesting turn of events. So right now, Brandenburg will have a lot of common borders with Austria. Let's see, what mission does Austria have? Austria. Okay, so mission. Make maze vault for us. Interesting. Well, as far as right now, the Empire looks pretty much Catholic, and it will stay that way. No, wait. Ottomans joined the Protestant League. Well, aren't you pretty much destroyed? Wait, do you have a good hair? Wow. Bad luck tutorial. He's going for his fourth. National Idea Group instead of finishing his other ones. is just sit back and look at the world from Brandenburg's perspective due to nothing else. Oh yeah, let's first look at how much did Muscovy take out of Shul. Oh, he made a beeline to Ming, of course. A tentacle, as it's more widely known here in this community. A tentacle to the heart of China. What is Ethiopia doing? Let's check. So he managed to take Alexandria, so he's on his way to taking the fourth blessing. Also, he took all of his Motapian cores, and he's able to fabricate claim on one of them, and he's actually building a spine attack in Moscow, which is rather interesting since he doesn't have any. The common borders though. Moving on, I'm just very, very bored. Sorry, guys, it's just, I don't know, today. Prague costs a lot to get cord, like close to 400. Right now it's 400 because of the war exhaustion. I almost finished taking one of their cores, probably pissed out Ulm, yep. And pissed out most of the people, only Utrecht remained. Which is right now getting conquered by... Maybe they're actually going to give Burgundy some of that land, because Burgundy didn't conquer anything in Europe. So So they shouldn't have any aggressive expansion. Yep. They should get some Utrechtian land in order to get closer to becoming the Dutch. Either that or France, as I said, one war with Great Britain and... It seems that Western trade got triggered for Japan because Great Britain explored them. Also, the whole colony of Bengal got occupied by Chinook because somebody couldn't wait for his colonial nation to finish before conquering. How many colonies? In total, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, 4. That's not just that ridiculous. But still. Anyways. So Muscovy started even before he finished his course. Let's check him a little bit. Okay, so he's actually at max military. Why? Oh, he woke up. Okay. Moving on. So he's conquering Ming. Not many problems there. He's actually behind in military tech, but his numbers probably make it a non-issue. Who knows what will happen? He might get a huge coalition. I mean, maybe the Chinese will realize that it's not such a good idea. Maybe. So, that's Moscow's top priority right now, conquering. Conquering continuously China. Can't blame them, that's some good land right there. He has quite a lot of money, quite a lot of manpower. He still had maximum manpower. How many mercenaries does he have? Not at all. Oh yeah, right, I forgot he actually has a very small army for his countryside. Right. I'm still waiting for the day that I'll see Russia. Let's see if Brandenburg will take his personal union or not. Oh, well, that's weird. Oh, that's why. So he took Ostfriesland and Frisia, because anything more would have netted him a coalition. Yeah, of course, because this is the Holy Roman Empire. So right now all we're going to do is wait and see if he'll take Bavaria or not. Sweden is helping people in their wars without getting anything out of them. As I said, Sweden doesn't have enemies, but at the same time he doesn't have anywhere to expand into except Norway. He should ask his friends to help him take Norway, or at least the last province of Denmark, which he could take by his own. Because he really should expand from time to time, I guess. Isn't it right, Mr. Sweden? Aren't you low on the development in Sweden? Okay, so aren't you? No, he's at 500 development. These lands actually are worth something. He almost finished annexing the Teutons, which is nice. That moment when he's actually converting his whole country to Prussian. He might actually want to culture flip and become Prussia. That's actually his plan, which is rather ridiculous. And I'm not talking about becoming Prussian, I'm talking about converting Swedish to Prussian. That's actually ridiculous and, in my opinion, a very, very big sink of diplomatic points. Who knows, maybe he had a lot of diplomatic to spare. I mean, what is he using it for, right? Now let's see him becoming Prussia. Oh wait, is that negative? Did he already switch his... No wait, no he didn't. In 10 months that will be finished. This war is completely done. What is he waiting for? Okay, so what else can I say? It is the waiting game, guys. Will they ever peace out Bavaria? Will he become Prussia the moment he annexes the Teutonic Order? Well, let's watch and see. Any other interesting wars? No. Only the one in that conquers Ming. The fact that Muscovy conquers Ming. Because why not? Because that's what Russia is doing, conquering Ming in 1584. Is he at least colonizing? Yes, he is. He's colonizing right there. He should have tried for the New World. Wait. So, Muscovy. Oh, yeah, right. He didn't explore it yet, of course. No, that's a problem. So. That was done, and he took the personal union. Very nice. I don't know why they're even bothering with aggressive expansion anymore. I mean, there's not much of the Holy Roman Empire left. Since Switzerland is a vassal of Austria, Rhine of Bavaria is a personal union of Brandenburg. So all that's left is this little cluster, which has a maximum of like 300 development, I guess. Yeah, can be more than 300. So let's say that they have 100,000. Oops, not more. Maybe 150,000, but still. They should just dig in as much as possible. So, Sweden. Let's see him finishing the annexation up. He did it, and he almost has the Dacia war. he might be able to stop it if he becomes Prussia right now, but I don't think it's in his... If Muscovy would peace out Ming, Sweden would have enough time to become Prussia if he switches to Prussian right now. Because he still has 4 more months. Yep. Oh wait, is it slower? Or is it only... Oh, it's only 2, I thought it was 5. So he has a little bit more, he has like 10 months. 5 months, but still... I really think that Muscovy should finish his war. So... let's look at the new world for a bit. Hindustan still didn't finish his colony. Britain is still trying to block Hindustan from making a bigger colony, while having a region called British Peru in Colombia, probably, which is ironic to say the least. He should probably core them in order to finish Colombia, I guess. Isn't it Colombia? Yes, it is Colombia. It's called Peru in Colombia, of course. Okay, so. Because he's trying to block Hindustan, he didn't finish the Canadian one yet. Okay, so. Sweden, are you able to do it? Let's see. Ignoring the fact that Muscovy wants to take 100% war in order to have over 100% over extension. Oh. I'm really wondering why doesn't he peace out, because he would have over 100% if he wants that much war with Moscow. Too bad, I mean Sweden is losing his chance to never have the Ducky War. Yep, too late, he'll have the Ducky War.
It's a good time.
Why didn't you finish the war with Ming so that Sweden can become Prussia before having the Ducky War?
Did
you
already get the Snake War?
Actually, I can't change to Prussian government right now.
Well, do it before the month passes.
Yeah, you don't want to take more.
You should pause it.
Unneeded thing.
Yep, too late. Deke war, fun stuff.
Well, I can handle it, but...
Oh, what?
I didn't culture switch yet, you know? That's the problem.
Yeah, and you lost a lot of stability. You should have paused so you were able to switch your capital.
I don't like pausing because of.
You
well,
don't need to switch capital anymore. You can just click a button.
And this is how I knew I fucked up.
Oh, and people are asking why I switch Alatan. I broke alliance with Muscovy.
Why you break the alliance with Muscovy?
Because of negative relations.
Oh, why do you hate Muscovy?
Why
does Muscovy hate you?
Why does he hate me?
Neighbor and Tari here.
He's riding with his Cossack. Arvita, you should stop. We are friends and you do stuff.
I don't get any event from Cossack, so it's not in my phone.
You need to kill them, like all of them.
They have 0 lands, but they got 20 influence and 80... And
oh, right, I forgot to state things. I'm 46.
Also, the new Electress Trier or something? Looks like the new Electress Trier. Also, if I didn't promise Austria to vote for it, I could make Brunswick the Emperor.
What the fuck? How to end Ducky War, guys?
Just hover over it and see.
Stability, I think.
Yeah, well, that's a costly thing.
Yeah, you have to beat up all of your rebels and then have one stability.
I can beat up. Oh, I got plus one stability just right now. Maybe I will. Yes, next month I will end this war, I think.
Accept that, please, Sweden. The both are dying, actually. I forgot about them.
Do you take for cash? I didn't check it.
I sold them for free.
I will give you back, the cash later on.
Now become Prussia. Oh, you don't have
Sweden, if you want to, you can send back your armies from China.
Are you sure? Fighting? Actually, you know what the problem is? I can't, for fuck's sake. Never mind.
You can, because I have land.
But I don't see you. I don't see your land.
I have
that's
your
Pomeranian
separatists, so
I will just kill them in a moment. Just give me a second. I have plenty of stuff to do and, all my army is at China. Kind of.
China?
Yeah. China. Why do you hate me, bro? Oh, actually, am I hating you?
No,
I think
you are actually.
Actually, you hate me because I stole maps from you.
It's okay.
Oh, he's like spamming me why I did broke with Muscovy. Can I troll him a little bit?
Only a little. Don't
go. Never mind. I will just tell
Norway
him that.
Norway is 54 without an heir. You should try roll marrying him for a personal union. Sweden.
Wait a sec, I'm doing stuff.
I'm waiting for you guys right now.
What are you talking about? Yes, I will.
I said that Norway is 54 years old and no heir. You should try getting a personal union.
Oh, that's a good thing, I think.
You didn't catch them.
I will just in a second. I'm just sieging back your lands, for fuck's sake. Just give me a
but
moment.
They're spreading separatism.
But...
Okay, so... Muscovy peaced out in the Ming War only when there was one month left to the Ducky War, so Sweden wasted a lot of admin on increasing his stability, which he would have done anyway when he culture shifted, but now he has to do it again when he culture shifts. Sad. Don't tell me that Brandenburg is actually selling all of his sea tiles to Sweden. Why are you doing it, Brandenburg? Why have you given in to the demon? Yeah, another culture shift, hooray! Anyone else culture shifting as hardcore as Sweden? No, because everyone has a better use of their monarch points, of course. It's a little bit of culture shift here on... Oh, these are just colonies, if I'm not mistaken. I might be mistaken. They have autonomy though. Let's look at the province history. Yep. Actually, it was from accounting. Yeah. Won't question it that much. He has interesting Barat. Let's look at the new wars that people are in. Oh, he's conquering Madagascar. Okay, next one. Muscovy. While at 150% of our extension. He was, now he's at 99%. Now conquering Korchin. Next up. Yep, everybody's ignoring him, no problem. Next up, Great Britain. At war with a country that won't exist any longer. Oh yeah. Fortifying Peru. Zorba's Republic, as he said, as he named it. Japan conquering from China as well, because he realized there won't be much left after Muscovy finishes. Burgundy is still finishing his conquest of African Great Lakes, or Congolese region, or however it's called. Ayutthaya finishing his Ayutthaya conquering Mongyang. Wait, Mongyang? Is he sending his vassal? No. It's not his word then. Nope, it's he send his word. And the Ottomans again at war with the Mamluks. Yay! Hooray for the Ottomans! Hindustan is, seems that Hindustan is actually trying to conquer the rest of Mexico, which will put him at odds with the next Spanish player whenever he will appear. At least California finally finished, so we have an Indian colonial nation. Great Britain at another war to destroy the natives. What more can I say? Right now I'm just waiting for for Sweden to become Prussia. And Austria is conquering the Moors. Nope, Spain is conquering the Moors. And Austria is helping the... Austria is helping the Spanish AI in his conquest of the Moors. At least they managed to convert the Moors. Another war perpetrated by Muscovy. He is trying really fast to take as much of China as possible. He gave that all to Oirat, I get it. So right now he's taking... Oh, of course. Not seeing anything else worth noting. Sadly. I don't know why Austria isn't also conquering the HRE, because it's not like they have any chance of passing any reform. Did they disinherit or something? Oh! Well, their ruler somehow died in order for his intelligent wife from England to rule for 4 years. Let's look at Sweden right now. Let's ask him why he isn't changing his capital right now. How's it going?
I need just one more year to culture convert last province. It's ending in 13 January of next year. So it's fine, I think.
You could just finish the culture conversion afterwards.
But I need to culture convert to Prussian, you know, and I don't want to, you know, lose my diplo, I mean admin power, because I am so behind in tech.
I wonder if I haven't sold your Rostock, but could you have formed Prussia?
No, I don't think so.
Like you said, you didn't have 1%.
But Rostock is not that much development, I think.
Also, you should convert Kolm or Kelm, though, the same thing, to Prussian. It's Polish.
I have separatist there, wiesz? You know?
Yeah, I'm just telling you later.
Oh, okay, I can do it.
Also, why do I have separatism? Dude, that's vassal land.
Because...
Actually, no, you don't. You don't have separate, you need to convert
okay.
It. That's what you need.
Okay, I got it.
Oh.
Yay, Prussia.
What is this? What is this dynasty over there?
Now we have two countries with very, very good military ideas.
Did you take the ideas? Yes, you did.
No, I didn't, no. I don't
yes,
care
you,
about ideas.
Yes, you did. I see you have Prussian ideas. Now we both founded the Kammergericht. They bred? They mean they breed. Maybe they bred.
Breed. Whatever.
Really, there's like no Swedish left. You converted all Swedish away.
Yeah. It looks good, actually.
Apparently there's no more such thing as Sweden.
Yep. So, let's make...
Good job.
Oh, I did a terrible stuff.
Yes, you did.
Oh, fuck me. Fuck well, you. I will just give you that land. Fuck it.
Okay.
Like, it's 1k. And we agreed. I was just, you know, so hyped that I created Prussia that I was not thinking about it.
Also, why is that in Prussian? That's disgusting.
Can you sell me that stuff?
Yes.
You need to make...
can, because I'm at war.
Oh, okay.
You need to make Stettin Pomeranian back, because that's disgusting.
So, finally Sweden became Prussia. I don't know why he would change his ideas. I mean, as far as to my knowledge, Sweden had pretty good ideas as well. But having that Prussian monarchy, that should really tip it in his favor. Because right now he could go full military ideas and he would have no problem abusing all it. Oh, they buffed. Is it buffed? If I recall correctly, it was 100 and now it's 50. Or am I recalling it wrongly? Hindustan again is conquering Mexico, while Great Britain is trying to make California. I guess it's still California, right? Nope, that's Alaska. He's conquered it for nothing. I mean, if he wants to make Alaska, sure, but not California. Muscovy circumnavigated Eurasia by themselves anyways. Okay, so we're going to play till global trade appears. so 9 more years. Did Ethiopia take colonization ideas? It seems so. Yep. Trying to get into inner. Wondering if Ethiopia is scared by the Burgundian Congo though. Ayutthaya failed, but he said to continue, so we're going to continue till 1600. And right now Bengal is still at the top, but English Channel is very, very close. Let's look at some ledger statistics because nothing new is happening. Let's take it. Let's spin it that way. Income comparisons. Country. Income. Highest income, Spain. Second highest, Ottomans. Third highest, Muscovy. Very close to Barat. Great Britain, very close to them as well. I mean, the first two have a great lead and the next three are very, very close to each other. Development-wise, Muscovy wins. They managed to beat out the Mughals. Let's look at the score. The first score is Barat, the second one is Ottoman. And Muscovy is 10th. Because he is probably the best player that doesn't have any victory card. I like it how France still has 107 enough score to be the 12th player when he doesn't exist anymore. Armies. Biggest army. Why don't you let me see the biggest army? I don't want it to be by country. Why? Army biggest, not name. Why is this bug here? No, I have the bug on everything now. No. My ledger bugged out, guys. I'm sorry. It happens. Yep, it's bugged out. Can't do anything about it. I cry every time. Having two people with Russian ideas will make for a more interesting game if there ever will be wars. Unfortunately, slowly but surely, the world is being occupied by players. So they will be forced to war against each other sooner or later. I mean, if we consider Poland and Spain to be players, the only place in Europe that isn't conquered yet is this quarter of Italy and this part of Germany. The rest of the whole of Europe is partitioned between players. India, again, they don't want to have common borders yet, but they're trying to have them in China. Hindustan is still at his war in Muscovy is still conquering China. Yep. Okay, so yep, he's still conquering China, Japan as well. And Bharat as well. So we have the only wars right now are the conquest of are conquering China. Let's see if the ledger fixed itself. Won't we? Nope, it's still only alphabetical no matter what. Yay! Hooray! I can't do anything. So much fun! Let's look at the conquest of China, because, you know, nothing else to do while we wait for global trade to appear, so we can finish. I'm actually wondering, did Austria do anything this session? Did it even matter that it was player controlled? I mean, They vassalized Switzerland, and that's about it. They don't have any aggressive expansion for quite some time. Keeping the empire independent can't help them anymore. It's too late for that. I mean, Brandenburg has half of it. Now Great Britain is trying to get a slice of Mexico, it seems. No, wait, it was just asked to come by Spain, because of course Spain needed help to conquer the Aztecs right now. Wait, isn't this... but how is Canada's capital in... Oh no, wait, he actually didn't conquer these guys. He realized the fact that he wouldn't make California like that, right? Moscow, it seems that he declared yet another war of conquest. Austria got a victory card, yay! And both the Ethiopian victory cards are on the Ottomans, of course. Any other country with new victory cards? Japan has one on Korea, nice. Anything else interesting happening? Post oh, the player war. Oh, no, it's not a player war, never mind. Or Austria will just AFK. Okay, anything else? Ethiopia finally managed to get to inner Africa. Burgundy is... Well, Brandenburg is finalizing his conquest of Bohemia. While at the same time probably giving some land to Burgundy. As I said before, they should stop caring about aggressive expansion since the players won't make use of it, so... Okay, any other war? Japan declared war on Ming. So Japan is trying to outdo Muscovy in conquering China. So that's happening right now. Stuff's happening. Let's just look at, at China, at the partitioning of it between the great powers. Yep. I'm just going to leave the screen there for some time while we're waiting because the ledger is bugged and it only may compare them by me. Are they at least in different wars? Nope, they're in the same war for some reason. They should have declared different wars in order to maximize the regions they can take. Their wish. It's their way of doing stuff. so Barad finally declared war on Tidore in order to unite, to conquer some more some more of the Philippines. Very nice. Burgundy is still consolidating his rule over Inner Congo, converting it, but he didn't accept any culture yet. I'm wondering if he'll either accept it or convert it. We will see. How is the land? Too bad Ayutthaya is at him right now to help them conquer Ming in order to get more of Ming before Muscovy finishes them all off, right? At least he almost finished conquering inner Africa. Yep. Well, I wasn't looking Prussia finally took some Norwegian land. Yeah, so the Ottomans left, so the last 3 years will be without the Ottomans. I wanna see global trade appear in Bengal. If Bengal is still the highest value trade node, I can't see. I can only... Wait, it's still... Oh, yes. And I broke it, yay, but at least it's still okay. We can still get it in India. We should have as many institutions spawn in India as possible, because India is the new power. India is the new Europe. We must understand this. This is the most important part. I'm sleepy. We really... 2.5 more years, guys. 2.5 more years. Great Britain again declared war on the rest of the... Peru. Well, the Spanish AI didn't manage to conquer the Aztec, because, of course. What? Did he disinherit his hair instantly? No, he didn't lose prestige, then what happened? I just saw his hair instantly change. And right now he disinherited his hair. Anything else of worry of note? Hindustan is finishing up the Aztecs. I trust in him more than I trust in the Spanish AI. And finally, Austria broke his alliance with Tuscany. He figured that he didn't have anything to conquer. Well, he did have, but he didn't want to conquer the HRE. And as such, he finally is conquering the rest of Italy. So he'll be pretty close to forming Italy if he wants to. Although he'll lack Genoa. Well, the same can be said about Burgundy, which right now lacks new Lancashire and Maine to form France, or Utrecht and Gelre to form the Dutch Republic, the Netherlands. Anything else worthy of note? Hindustan is cracking down hard on the. The Aztecs, and China started conquering Muscovy from behind. the Orthodox Germany or the Orthodox China, whichever is more frightening. Or Sony California, or Sony Mexico. Or Protestant South America. Yay, Norway finally finished his colonial nation, Vinland. Prussia might get a free colonial nation if he manages to complete annex Norway. If I'm not mistaken, and they changed that. Okay, moving on. 1.5 more years until global trade. I hope that it appears instantly. Burgundy is moving up, he started taking Songhai. He saw that Ethiopia is closing in and he wanted to get as much of Africa as possible before Ethiopia gets to it. Should be able to finish up Marawi. He probably didn't record them yet. Claim them yet, sorry. I'm sleepy right now. Ayutthaya, right. Forgot, you want to see your country. That was AFK. Sadly, he didn't conquer anything else. He should have joined them in a crusade against Ming, but no such luck because it's AI. He actually broke his alliances with Japan and Hindustan, I guess. We don't have any more player allies. Don't know if it's... if it's their fault or the AI's fault, but no. And right now you're actually losing versus rebels, I guess? Well, that's not good at all. Your army should easily beat them. Let's hope that you won't... let's hope that the army AI won't fail. Yeah, you're alright, you just didn't expand, I guess. Also, you don't have any legitimacy or a heir. So maybe your dynasty died off already and is going to die off again. Well, Ethiopia at least has a shinier name because he started conquering inner Africa. He should go for the rest of the Mamluks in Tripoli. But maybe he wants to leave them to Spain, who knows. Can't really say, it's his choice. He at least has choices in directions to conquer, unlike other countries. Why did he pause? He didn't leave. Well, two more months and we should see the global trade appear in Bengal as far as I know. Ignoring that, Bengal should have the highest trading power. Wait, what? Lion or Lima? Name, why is Lima? This isn't names. What are they? What are they comparing them with? These aren't names. Oh. Right, so Ashanti insulted Snakes of Friend. So Spain declared war on Ashanti. Everybody ran from the... Forgot its name. I give up. Moving on. Global trade. Global trade. Let's look at Hindustan, because Hindustan should get it anyways. Hindustan. Maybe Samurai Lord of Wii is AFK and doesn't accept the fact that it appeared? I don't think so. Nope, he's not. Too bad it has an empty harsh, it seems. I mean, time to happen. So we're going to wait. Oh, it appeared. And it appeared in Hindustan, as I knew it. I was sure it will appear in Hindustan. It's the highest value trade in my life now. Okay, we are free. So it's been done. Well, guys, see ya next week. Hopefully, then I'll be less lethargic. I am not promising anything, though. Bye.